new singles all reached number one in the UK chart, something not even Michael Jackson or Madonna could achieve.
And they're one of the most successful music groups this country has ever produced, selling over 50 million albums worldwide. Please welcome Judith, Ethel, Keith and Bruce, the wonderful Seekers. If that's not enough that you've been going since 1965, so you formed in 65 and then had that worldwide hit.
We formed in, well, 64, at the end of
64.
Yes, even 63 in
63,
Melbourne.
63, we started in the Treble Cliff.
Yes. That's near in the Melbourne. Treble Cliff, yes, I remember that.
When coffee was the go.
Yeah,
when Vienna, Vienna coffee, do you remember that? Black with the whipped cream on it.
That's
wasn't
right.
Amazing.
We were so cosmopolitan.
that's why we got paid for the gig.
You've been together for a long time. You
we
must
have.
Get sick of each other.
No.
No.
Really?
Do you get sick of each other?
Well,
no.
No, we have a system every now and then one of us will leave the room so the other three can take the message. Works very well.
Can I ask, in 63 you would have been paid in guineas?
No, we weren't paid at all.
Is that true?
Free coffee and toasted sandwich.
All the spag bol we could eat.
Well, sing for your supper was an interesting term in those days, because I did.
That's how a lot
of people started. Yeah. I remember I did all my gigs for nothing, but that's because I couldn't sing. No. You can sing.
Are we being paid for this show? Don't know.
Oh, hang on,
in
I'll
guineas.
Just check the
Oh, no, we had our coffee. I'm sorry, we've already had our coffee.
Guineas rattling around somewhere. They're sewn into a teddy bear. Now, part of the reason the Seekers are here is to talk about a tour that's taking place through massive stadiums in October. It's going to be absolutely massive. You were sort of personally approached by André Rieu to be part of his, what is it called, Celebration of Music tour. Yeah.
Mm. Yes, we were very surprised to have the invitation. Delighted.
What happened, Judith?
Simply they got in touch and André Rieu himself phoned our management and we weren't thinking of doing tours at all. We've all got our individual busy lives, actually. Mm. But this was something very special, and of course the tours...
Oh, it'll be fabulous.
Yeah, and we've never ever toured with a full orchestra. Yeah.
I know.
So, yeah, so André Rieu, of course, has the Johann Strauss Orchestra.
65-piece orchestra.
Oh, it'll be brilliant. Yeah. That, and you've never worked? I can't believe you've never worked with...
Never
toured.
We did once.
Well, not a tour. Never toured.
No, never toured.
Yeah,
no.
We did that Mammoth My Music Bowl concert in front of the orchestra and the band.
I remember
the military band. But never toured. So there we go. This is our first chance.
Well, the song, I think the thing that excited me, we're a bit like kids in a lolly shop in a way, because to hear those songs that have lasted for so long with that sort of backing behind it, I mean, it's just, you feel uplifted thinking about it.
Mm. I hope it takes you to Europe. Because, I mean, you were popular world over, but with him and the orchestra and everything over there, that could be a new career for you all.
Well, we're actually going over prior to the tour to Europe to rehearse with the orchestra for 3 days.
Will you stay at the castle? He's got a castle.
No, that's the papier-mâché one that he brings in.
No, there was a documentary. It must be worth $1 squillion. His place where he lives is just exquisite. It's beautiful.
We hear some terrific things about him. Actually, there was one lovely quote coming back to, you know, what we might do with him, and someone asked him about the Seekers, what they would do on the show and whether they'd go on, and he said, well, that depends on whether we like each other. It's such a simple thing, and that's exactly what it is. It's so important.
He's very at one with all the people that work for him.
Apparently,
they all stay in the same hotel. Mm. No one gets treated differently, and I think that's a good core, isn't it?
Yeah. And the lovely thing is that he has built a very special audience, and that's very harmonious with our kind of audience.
Yes.
And a little bit happened with him that an audience revealed itself that people didn't realise was there. And the same with the Seekers records back in the 60s, because it was all long hair and electric instruments when we arrived in England, and our sound was very fresh, and people didn't realise that niche was there in the marketplace.
Yeah, it's true. And you guys are going to perform for us shortly, and what I noticed backstage was you warming up and doing the vocal exercises like more, which I honestly you don't see too often these days. Do you think the craftsmanship has gone a little bit from modern music?
Well, I suppose they're all very professional. Sorry, Kathy, but I don't really know what I'm talking about here, but I assume that most young people, when they get their break, they get it very quickly, and then they're thrust into the limelight and they go, God almighty, I don't know what I'm doing. So they have to backtrack quickly, whereas we cut our teeth years before, Judith with her jazz, us with Morris Plonk's Moonshine 5, and Keith and I had...
Morris Plonk!
Yeah.
Absolutely.
an iconic band in Australia. Bluegrassy stuff, and I forget what I was about to say now. The Eagles are the classic example. They do about an hour warm up before their shows.
Do they really?
As a vocal group, you have to. Mm. You know, it takes good half an hour or so before you can get out and sing.
But I heard you rehearsing, you're sounding better than ever.
Thank you.
Well, that's nice. Thank you.
But you've all worked all the way through. You haven't really.
Yes. Oh, yeah, we kept in touch. Yeah.
And yeah. No, we're still singing.
Well, our last tour was in 2004, so that wasn't too long ago.
No, not really, no.
Yeah, well,
not in a span since 1963, that's not long at all.
No, I agree. Now, they're going to be back to perform with us for us later, but for now, please thank the Seekers.
Thank you.
Yes, they're getting set to tour with André Rieu on the Celebration of Music tour. Now, this song that you're about to do, you did in 1965.
Yes, absolutely.
It was a worldwide hit, was unheard of at the time.
For an Australian band, we were the very first, yes.
Yeah,
number
it's fabulous,
one.
Isn't it? Mm, yeah. And here they are this morning to perform one of their greatest songs, I'll Never Find Another You. Take it away! Better than ever and just like yesterday.